where we are?
Sure. My name's Simon Colgan. We're at the World's End. You can see from around us the devastation. We're going through a fairly decent refurb this winter.
So, how long have you? When did you first take on the World's End?
2006, April 2006. We bought it. We came in on a lease, and then we're lucky enough to buy the building. And this refurbishment that has kind of been in our head ever since that time, 2006.
And what are you doing as part of the refurbishment?
Over those years, we've been able to see where the business is strong, the business is weak, where we need to be better, where we need more space, more availability. And this time that we've learnt over those years. Well, the thing that we identified very early on when we came in here was that the outside area is our strong point. We demolished the garage and added the conservatory for extra seating inside. But essentially, the joy of here is the river, the views of river, sitting outside, the calmness, the stillness and the beauty of where it is. So we are looking to make our outside areas as strong and as big as we possibly can. Purely because when the sun comes out, people come out and they want to sit. And one of our biggest problems is having to turn people away because we don't have the space to sit them. So this development will make inside, hopefully we'll see an extra 60 inside and an extra 60 outside. Yeah, we.
So how would you describe what sort of style of pub is the World's End?
Well, it's very much a traditional pub, and that's how we'd like it to be. People come to a historic place like Knaresborough and expect a pub on the waterside to be traditional. So we're going to enhance that. We're going to make it even more traditional. And just the perception of what people want, we're going to try and give them. So, but we're going to take away all the problems we had in the past, terrible toilets, space, and we're hopefully going to fix all those problems in one go and make it much better going forward.
So will there be any changes to the things like the beers or the menus?
We are looking now, as everybody's looking, at adding more gluten-free options, vegetarian options, but mainly we're going to stay. We do a lot of food because people love pub food, and that's we're going to give that. We're going to make a bigger bar, so hopefully waiting times will be reduced, which is another problem that we've always had in the past. Well, we have had to. We demolished the old conservatory, demolished the toilets, and we're now nearly finished digging out what was underneath the decking previously, so that we can put the toilets will go underneath where the decking was, so then the decking will run straight the way across. We put a steel frame in and then create a box where the deck will run over the top. And luckily, the next door neighbour is also taking a huge tree down, so the views that we'll be able to offer for this summer will be amazing. It'd be a sort of perfect view of the river, and we hope to be done by mid to end of March, and then hopefully open when they allow us to open. You'll go, there'll be a doorway there, and where they've dug out there, that's going to be the toilets.
Yeah.
And then a steel frame's going to be built here, that wall comes out, and then the deck will run at that height all the way up to the building. So you imagine,
yeah.
This is the tree that's coming down, that huge one there.
Yeah.
So you imagine being sat at that height up there, looking over there,
yeah.
Unparalleled views.
Fantastic.
So then where they've chopped the deck there, that's where the staircase will be, and then you'll come up and it'll run all the way through here. Yeah. So we've added the two toilet decks to the building.
So the toilets be here or over there?
The toilets were there.
Yeah.
You can see where the footprint of the toilets are. We've gained that. And by digging out underneath the deck, which is space we never had before, we gained that. And there, this is John, who's the main contractor. He's got all sorts of mad ideas for it fitting in with how that perception I was talking about before. So, the pub will run all the way to that outside wall. So the problem I've had in the past is because I can only sit 60 people inside. That's my capacity. So I'll be able to sit 120. I will be able to go back to putting live music in, which is what we used to do. But when the food got very, very strong, we couldn't have live music because people were coming in and out with plates, and they weren't able to work side by side. So I had to stop the music. This means that I will be able to appeal to much more local people during the winter.
Yeah.
Because I can do that. I can put live music on. I can put events on what people remember from the World's End. You know.
Yeah.
And that so log burner. It's just gonna feel brilliant.